like that.
Don't mind me, just playing with my dragon. Welcome to Child's Book Review, read book, play, not enjoy, not enjoy, not today we've got Eragon. Because the book czar told me to. All hell's the book czar. Now, you're all familiar with my review, so I'm not even going to say that part anymore. So let's scorecard, get right into it. The premise of Eragon is that there is one boy, one dragon, and a world of adventure. Kind of stealing it off the back cover here. But a dude named Eragon finds a polished blue stone in a forest, and he thinks it's like his lucky discovery for a poor farm boy. Perhaps it'll buy his family some meat for the winter. But when the stone brings a dragon hatchling, Eragon soon realizes he has stumbled upon a legacy nearly as old as the Empire itself. So overnight, his simple life is shattered, and he's thrust into a perilous new world of destiny, magic, and power. So it's your run-of-the-mill, you know, adventure story with dragons. The premise. It's a boy finds a dragon and gets to be an epic dragon rider, and he has to take on the evil empire. So, you know, Star Wars mixed with Lord of the Rings mixed with Game of Thrones, I guess. So, yeah, premise, you know what? I'll give it 3 stars. Nothing, it's not super original, but dragons are always good. Okay, writing. So let's do some actual depth into this review now. So the writing, I have long heard that writing on this thing was not really good. I knew that a teenager had written it. I think it was published when he was 19, so he was probably, you know, 15, 16, 17 when he was writing it, and you can goddamn tell. That said, the writing's not bad in, like, 50 Shades of Grey Twilight sense, where it's just bad writing. It's more, it's just not good writing. So he's not doing tons of writing faux pas. He's not using excessive adverbs for the most part. He's not using overly flowery, just ridiculous language. He's not using tons and tons and tons of sedisms. He certainly does use some of them. The main detriment to the writing is mostly a rushed feel to it, a lack of depth into the prose itself, where it skims along a little too quickly. Is mainly what you'll notice, which is common with young writers. They're not putting enough in. Now, he does do some of those faux pas that I mentioned. He does use sedisms quite a few times, quite a few adverbs, but not to the scale of really, really badly written stuff like Twilight and 50 Shades of Grey. The main points where you notice the writing not being up to snuff is during action scenes. So there's a lot of action scenes in the book, but when they happen, he'll be doing this, and then all of a sudden kind of like he skips over that and he's over here, and then he skips over that and he's over here, and they're not connected real well. You're not getting a good visualization of the action, what he's doing. He bowls an Urk or whatever the hell they call them, an Urgle, over, and then they disengage somehow, and he gets away from this monster, and then you're like, well, how exactly did that happen? The action scenes are when it really shows up. Another one is in the dialogue. All the characters talk the same way. He did make an attempt very briefly at one point where the characters affect an accent, which wasn't the worst affectation I've ever seen, but certainly not the best, and it was just very briefly through there. Throughout the majority of the book, all the characters are talking the same. Now, that said, writing, what I am deeply, deeply appreciative of is that he didn't try to write in epic language the way that Lord of the Rings is written, because I don't like it when it's done well. I don't enjoy reading Tolkien. When it's done poorly, and I've seen some examples of it done poorly, when I was first published, I was at the house, and a girl had written an epic fantasy book with the elves and all of that shit, and god damn, her prose was awful. It was just, it's a parody of Tolkien when people try to affect that style, because almost nobody can do it. I don't enjoy when it's done well. When it's done poorly, it's just like drilling a goddamn nail into my face, you know. But so thankfully, Pliny didn't do that. It's written in straightforward English, but it's not good. It's a teenager. It's obviously a teenager who wrote it, albeit a very talented teenager. I am
just going to go out on a limb and say that he is a more than competent writer now. I think he's like my age, maybe a little older than me. So he has some experience under his belt. So he's going to be a good writer now. But this book was not well written. So writing, I'll give it 2 stars. It was bad, but it wasn't horrendous. World building. I would give it 3 or 4 stars. Because it does have some history. It does have different segments. It didn't feel completely fake, like a parody fake world. I did enjoy the kind of sort of history of the dragon riders, the good people in there. As far as the history of the land, it was very, very simple. There was dwarves, and then elves, and then humans. And then that's all it's been since the dawn of time. So it doesn't have any of the depth historically of Lord of the Rings or Song of Ice and Fire. I mean, it doesn't even scratch the surface. Which, speaking of scratching the surface, let's just put it this way. This has a nice veneer of a world. But if you peck at it, you scratch at it, you're going to poke right through that veneer and you're going to see emptiness behind it. Whereas with Lord of the Rings or Song of Ice and Fire, you scratch that veneer, you're going to find depth in there. You're going to find a whole layer of more stuff. And you scratch past that stuff, you're going to find more stuff. So those worlds are just 1,000 times more intricate than this. That said, it didn't feel entirely terrible. I've read sci-fis where the world building, it was much, much worse. But I have to knock a star because of the goddamn languages in here. Ploni invented languages. To me, that is a very big no-no unless you were an extremely talented linguist. You speak several languages fluently. You mastered those languages. You understand the grammar scientifically, top to bottom, on all of the languages. And as a teenager, that's not a chance in hell that you're going to have that kind of skill set. Tolkien was able to create languages, and he had doctorates out the yin yang, I believe. But he was an unequaled linguist. When you create a language or attempt to create a language and you don't have that kind of understanding of other languages, what's going to happen is what happened in this book. You have silly sounding languages. It just sounds silly. It's very obviously just a clone of English where the words are changed. And he's just like making words up off the top of his head by spouting out random sounds. I could not pick out any basis in here. I couldn't pick out much of a consistency when they were speaking the ancient language or the dwarf language or the elf language, which was also the ancient language. But all the languages, they just all sounded goofy. They had no sound similarity between them. Whereas in Lord of the Rings, you can tell when somebody's speaking the dark language of Mordor or Elvish. You can tell that they have different sounds to them, even though I can't pick them up. When the names of the places, which really came into play, they just sound so damn fake. I mean, let's just go down through the map right here. Narda, Vroingard, Doru Arriba, a shark tooth. That one's good. Kuasta, Tirm, Feenster, Eros, Beerlind, Yom, Udin, Parlim, Reevestump. There's a good one. And then he'd have entire passages written in the language where it's like, okay, yeah, I get it. You invented a damn language that really has no depth whatsoever to the language, and it's just goofy sounds that you picked out and put in. Okay, this goofy sounding word means this goofy sounding word means that. It was hugely detrimental to the book. If you don't have that background, I'm not saying that you can't invent words to put into the books, but do it the way that Martin did with the Song of Ice and Fire, where he admits he has some Dothraki words, and he has some the other language, I can't think of the name in it. But he doesn't have the languages all written out sending into his desk drawer. He just has a couple words. When they're speaking them in the show, they had linguists come in and create those languages. People who, that's what their life revolves around. People who are experts in their field. And that's why those languages sound real. If you don't have that, you can't... Unless you're some kind of goddamn prodigy, which Ploni, he's a talented, very smart kid when he wrote this, but he wasn't a prodigy. So, the language, I've got to knock a star off, so for world building, I'll put 2 stars. Hey, humor. Yeah, there were some funny parts in here, and they hit for the most part, missed every once in a while, so 3 stars. Move quickly through that section. Characters. You're going to be able to start telling something, but we'll do it in the overall wrap-up. But the characters, you had Eragon, You know, the first time I've ever heard people talking about this book, I assume they were talking about Lord of the Rings with Eragon. Or Harry Potter with Aragorn. You know, obvious. I don't even want to call it like a tribute to Lord of the Rings. I feel like it's just like kind of picking from Lord of the Rings when you name the book after a major character in Lord of the Rings. Yes, the spelling's different. The pronunciation's not. Yeah, I just going through trying to figure things out. Bron is just the typical, oh, wise master, let me teach you things. Now, going back to the writing, which probably shouldn't, but there are a lot of cliches. And, you know, the cliche of throw a stick to him and say, defend yourself, you know. The characters were just your stenciled cutouts that you plop into the storyline with no real depth. You had your very stereotypical cliched, Eragon doesn't know his parentage. His friend was the mysterious. We don't know his past. I can't even remember his friend's name, which we'll talk about more in the overall. And I finished this book last night. But the characters had no depth to them whatsoever. So 2 stars. Journey. You all know what that means by now. So did I enjoy reading the book? The short answer is no. Did I read the book? Yes. That said, the only reason I really finished this book was because the book czar had commanded me to read it. I had to do a review on it. I'm not going to review a book that I haven't read in its entirety. I was about 200 pages from the end. It's like 300 pages into this book. And I wanted to put it down. I wanted to go along to something else. The pacing was fine. But it was just, it had no clinching force to it. It didn't grab me and say, let's go for a ride. It was just like, well, here's what's going on. Some stuff's happening. Oh, okay, something's bad. And it just didn't grip me. But the pacing wasn't awful. It didn't have long segments of them sitting around and talking. It only had one goddamn song in it, which I got to skip. So it wasn't Lord of the Rings bad. So I'll give it 3 stars on the journey, but I would have put it down and not finished it if I hadn't been commanded to read it. So Deus Ex Machina. Woo! Yeah, this book is filled up with it. I mean, Eragon gets captured again and again and again. And going back to cliches, he gets captured a lot, which is a cliche. He passes out after every damn battle, which is a cliche. He passes out when he doesn't really even apparently have any new injuries. He passes out for a couple days and wakes up and people tell him what happened. That's a cliche that I'm very, very sick of seeing. We're under the Deus section. So the main thing is he gets saved every goddamn time. I think there was only one part in this book where he saved himself. Every damn time somebody's showing up to save him with either a new ability or a character that was not previously introduced, that's pretty bad Deus. The story just saves him. It's plot armor. He can't die. He's the main character. So the Deus was pretty rife throughout the book. So we're going to give it 2 stars. Okay, so ending. Spoiler, all that crap, you know. The ending, there was a major battle in the Varden, the secret fortress. And as I said in the writing section, he can't write action worth the damn. He wasn't up to it. And when you have a major battle happening, you need to be able to write action really well. Instead, he was just skipping around on what was the battle. He'd fight here for a minute, then he'd fly around and rest. And then he'd fight here for a minute, then he'd fly around and rest. Then he had to go fight the bad guy, and then he got saved with his dragon from the Deus. I mean, I knew it was going to end up like that when the battle was about to happen and there was 10 pages left in the book. So I was like, okay, yeah, he's going to really shit the bed on this. His writing chops are just not up to it. And then after the ending, he passed out, of course, without any real, he got cut on the back, I think, but he just passed the hell out for 2 days. Because, you know, he had to. It was the end of a battle. He had to pass out. And while he was passed out, he had some weird fucking dream that I wasn't paying attention to because I was just glad that the book was almost over. And then he had to continue his adventure. So, ending, I'm going to give it 2 stars. So, overall, the best way I can describe my feelings for this book are indifferent. If you noticed throughout this review, I wasn't able to get into much precision and really talk about certain points. Because this book, I finished reading it last night, and I already can't remember much of it. It did not grip me. It didn't pull me in. I just read it. I didn't live it. I didn't enjoy it. I didn't dive into it the way that I do with most books. I read it, and it slipped all right out again because it wasn't holding me. It wasn't arousing my passions either in a positive or negative manner. When I absolutely hate a book, I'm going to be paying attention to it. I'm going to be paying attention. Why did I hate this book? Why? So then I can really go in and rail against it the way that I did with The Cursed Child. With this one, I didn't hate it, but I didn't like it either. It was indifferent. It was just there. And as I said, I would have put it down halfway through the book if I hadn't been commanded to read it. It's just... it's not well written. The story is not an uninteresting story. The pacing is not terrible. The characters aren't hilariously bad, but they're not good on any of those either. It's just wallowing down the middle. I'm just indifferent to the book. I have absolutely no desire to pick up future books or other books in this series, even though I know factually that they're going to be better. Because a teenager wrote this, a guy who has writing experience under his belt, who's been published, who's gone through edits, he's going to be writing the rest of the series. He's going to be a better writer. And I'm sure by now he is a very fine writer. But reading this book didn't instill that desire to continue on with this story. And I'm not a big epic fantasy guy to start with. The only series that I've really ever loved is A Song of Ice and Fire. Now, there's some other Garth Nix type books that I've really enjoyed, which are probably technically epic fantasy. It's not as bad as Lord of the Rings. I'd pick this thing up and read it in a heartbeat instead of Lord of the Rings. And I'm trying to find different ways to say it, but I'm just indifferent to it. So overall, I'm going to give it 2 stars. Whereas a book that I didn't enjoy reading, a book that I wouldn't have finished reading, but I did finish it and I didn't hate every moment of my life while I was reading it. It kind of just felt like wasted time. Time that I won't remember using. That has been my review of Eragon, a book I wouldn't have reviewed if it hadn't been for the Bookzar. I wouldn't have read it, to be honest with you, either. But that's what the Bookzar is for, to command me to read books that I wouldn't. So all hail the Bookzar until he commands me of what book to review for next month. And yeah, you can bribe him if you want. But whatever. Until next time, keep reading.